Yes, yes.
Good morning. Today we're here visiting the Hill of Muses and the Philopappos monument, which you can see right behind me. According to Pausanias, an ancient peripatetic writer of the 2nd century AD, the highest of the three hills west of the Acropolis took its name from the poet Musaeus, who lived, taught, and was buried there. So it's the Hill of the Muses. The rock cut square to the northeast of the summit, which affords niches for statues, you see, benches and altars for offerings, is claimed to belong to the funeral monument of Musaeus. It is more probable, however, that the hill took his name from a sanctuary of the Muses, to whom the hill must have been dedicated. The prevalent and commanding position of the Hill of the Muses, directly across the Acropolis, was the stronghold of the Athenians, who, according to myth, fought against the Amazons. Throughout the ages, it was used as a fortress of primary strategic significance during major military operations. In the 5th century BC, before Christ, the Athenians incorporated the hill within the Themistocleon fortification, whereas the Diatichisma was constructed on its summit in the 4th century BC. In 294 before Christ, Demetrius Poliorcetes had a small fort built known as the Macedonian Fort, annexing the Diatichisma wall, where he installed a garrison to guard the city. Garrison for Rome. In the 2nd century AD, a burial monument 12 meters in length, height, was erected on the Hill of Muses, which has since prevailed over the area. It takes its name from its founder, Gaius Julius Philopappos, prince of Commagene of Upper Syria, and benefactor of Athens. This monument is made of pentelic marble. Can you admire it, please? On a porous crepis. Its monumental curved facade facing the Acropolis is divided in two zones. The upper zone comprises three deep niches to support seated statues. In the central niche, Philopappos, headless, is depicted sitting on a throne with the inscription Philopappos, son of Epiphanes, on the dam of Beds, of Beza. In the left niche, according to the inscription, King Antiochos, son of King Antiochos, the fragmentary figure of Philopappos' great-grandfather is portrayed. According to the inscription which survived until the 15th century, the founder of the Seleucid dynasty, King Seleucus, son of Antiochos, dictator, was depicted on the right niche. Now the lower zone is a relief frieze depicting Philopappos on a quadriga flanked by lictors. The burial chamber in the form of Naiskos, which housed the Philopappos sarcophagus, was behind the monument. So his sarcophagus is here. Now the monument survived intact until the 15th century, but gradually fell victim to vandalism and the elements. It was partly restored by the civil engineer Balanos in 1904. Thank you very much. Now, we are now in the Areopagus Hill, another hill of Athens. The Areopagus, a rocky outcrop approximately 115 meters high, is situated between three other hills, the Acropolis, the Pnyx, the Pnyx, and the colonos and Goreos. Its name probably derives from Ares, the god of war, Ares, and the Ares Erinyes or Semes, or Semnes, also called the Eumenides. Underground goddesses of punishment and revenge. Underground, Chthonis, theodes, Simorias, και Τσεκδίκησης. Underground goddesses of punishment and revenge. A judicial body, the Areopagus Council, met on this hill to preside over cases of murder, sacrilege, and arson. The Areopagus was also a place of religious worship. Among the several sanctuaries located here was that of the Semnes, or Eumenides, probably located in a cavity at the northeast side of the hill. In the Mycenaean and Geometric periods, the northern slope of the hill served as a cemetery, which contained both vaulted tombs and simple seized graves. From the 6th century before Christ onwards, the hillside as a whole became a residential quarter belonging to the fashionable street district of Melite. Cutting still evident in the bedrock attests to the district's many roads, wells, drains, reservoirs, floors, and irregular buildings. Access to this neighborhood was provided by stairways cut right into the living rock. Now, by the late Roman period, between 4th and 6th centuries after Christ, four luxury houses, which probably served as philosophical schools, located at the north slope of the hill, had supplanted the houses of the classical area. The Areopagus is also associated with the spread of Christianity into Greece. So we pass from the Archaic, Mycenaean, to the Roman, and now to the Christian period in Greece. Sometime near the middle of the first century after Christ, the Apostle Paul is said to have converted a number of Athenians by teaching the tenets of the new religion from the summit of the hill, right here now. Among the converts was Dionysius the Areopagite, the patron saint of the city of Athens, who, according to tradition, was the city's first bishop. Remains of the church, named in his honor, are preserved on the northern slope of the hill. Can we see them later? Now, the church of St. Dionysius the Areopagite was a three-aisled basilica with a narthex at west, central apse, diaconikon, which is the apse terminating the southern nail, and prothesis, the apse terminating the northern nail. It was built in the middle of the 16th century, and it was probably destroyed by an earthquake in 1601, unfortunately. The church and grounds were completely enclosed to the north and west by the monumental Archbishop Palace. This two-story palace was built between the middle of the 16th and the end of 17th century and consisted of a complex of rooms which included warehouses, a kitchen, a dining hall, and two wine presses. Thank you very much. Here we can watch a restored drawing of the church of St. Dionysius the Areopagite and the Archbishop's Palace of the 16th century.